Students, so student, today we will discuss the solution of the weekly test. So students, we have discussed the chapter number 1, nutrition in plants. I think you read the chapter very carefully and also know the what do you mean by the nutrition, autotrophic nutrition, heterotrophic nutritions. So students, now let us discuss the solution of the weekly test, class 7th science. Students, question number 1, which of these is formed along with the glucose during photosynthesis? What do you mean by the photosynthesis? Student, photosynthesis is a process by which plants make their own food with the help of the carbon dioxide, water, sunlight and chlorophyll. Okay, so what is the question? Which of these is formed along with the glucose during photosynthesis? So student, what is the reaction of the photosynthesis? What is the word equation for the photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide plus water arrow form oxygen plus glucose. Okay, so last product you can see in the option, oxygen, water, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. So student, during the photosynthesis, plant use the carbon dioxide and also water used, and they take nitrogen from the nitrogenous bacteria from the soil. And but in this question, what is the form along with the glucose during the photosynthesis? So student, answer is oxygen. Correct answer is oxygen. Now student, second question, which of these helps to transport starch from the leaves to the other parts of the plant? Xylem, phloem, storia and stoma. Xylem conducts the water from the roots to the other parts of the plant. Phloem, yes, also this also transport starch from the leaves to the other parts of the plant. So correct answer is phloem. Phloem help us to transport starch from the leaves to the other parts of the plant. Now student, fill in the blanks. Solution is used to make test for the presence of the starch in leaves. So which solution is used to make the test for the presence of the starch? So student, we should iodine solution. We use the iodine solution is used to make test for the presence of the starch in the leaves. Okay student, next. The organism for which the parasite derive nutrients. Listen carefully. What is the question? The organism from which the parasite derive nutrients. We have discussed this question also. This is present in between also and in exercise question also. Is called the host. What is the answer of this questions? Host. So host is the organism from which the parasite derive nutrients. Understand? Now fifth question, the exchange of the gases in plant takes place through tiny pores present in the leaves. So listen student, tiny pores present in the leaves. What are these? Stomata. So stomata are present in the leaves of the plant in lower surface mainly. So the exchange of gases also takes place by the stomata. So correct answer of this question is stomata. Next, the opening and closing of the stomata are controlled by, there is a bean like structure that is called the, we can say the stomata. And opening and closing of the stomata is controlled by the guard cell. Which cell? Guard cell. So opening and closing of the stomata are controlled by the guard cell. Understand? Now we will discuss the true and false. Listen carefully. Organism that depend on the other organism for food are called heterotrophs. So you must know what is the autotrophs and heterotrophs. So student, what do you mean by the autotrophs? Auto means self. Entropes means synthesize. So autotrophs means the organism that make their own food. But heterotrophs, what are heterotrophs? Hetero means other. Trophs means synthesize, other synthesize. They depend on the other organism for their food. So read this question. Organism that depend on the other organism for food are called heterotrophs. This is true because heterotrophs depend on the other organism. Understand? Now, photosynthesis can take place in the presence of water. If water is present, photosynthesis takes place? No. Photosynthesis takes place only in the presence of the sunlight. Sunlight is necessary for the photosynthesis. So, this is false. Now, next. Cascata is a complete parasite. Yes, student, this is true. Why cascata is a complete parasite? Because cascata does not have the chlorophyll. They do not prepare their own food. They completely depend on the other plant for their food. So, cascata is a complete parasite. This is the true. Now, next. Pitcher plant is an insectivorous plant. Yes, student, pitcher plant is an insectivorous plant. They depend on the insect for their food. They prepare on their food, but they depend on the insect for the nitrogenous product. So, student, pitcher plant is an insectivorous plant. This is also true. So, I hope you understand all the answer of these questions. So, students, okay, bye.